Good morning, Meghan.
Good morning. How are you?
I am good. Girl, let me tell you what I love about your music is that you have the anthem songs. Like a good song, good for a minute. The anthems will last for decades, starting with All About That Bass for any person size 2 and above, because I feel like we start fat shaming at size 2, right? There were several people that song was pitched to. They didn't take it. Why did you take it?
Oh, well, because no one else did. And L.A. Reid, I guess, is to thank for that. He reached out and said, well, whoever's singing the song, just get them. And I was the songwriter and the singer of the song with my friend Kevin Kadish. And then I just went with it, and we're still here somehow.
It's interesting sometimes how we'll put things out there, and it's like, why not start where it started, right? And it just took off like wildfire because, again, so many people could relate to it. And then Lips Are Moving, that is everybody's breakup anthem, get out of here. The other thing is I love is that your choice of words, like, let's Marvin Gaye get it on. Where did that line, Marvin Gaye get it on, come from?
Oh, that was all Charlie Puth, man. He's amazing. He's so talented, and he had that song, and when I met him, we were both like coming up in the industry, and I begged him. I was like, let me sing this with you. I love Marvin Gaye. I love what you did with this song. I have this doo-wop feel on my album. We gotta do this. And luckily he let me do it, and I love that song.
Yeah, the next line needs to be, let Barry White make it right.
Yes, you can write.
When we listen to your songs, they are so uplifting, so fun, but they also are beautiful. And the vocals are complex. The music is complex. It's like a big Broadway number at times. What is your music background? Tell us what it is.
Thank you. I love you. My mom listened to a lot of 80s, a lot of like Billy Joel and like A Prayer, like Madonna. So I loved big, big songs with extra vocals. And then my dad loved listening to like James Brown and Ray Charles and a lot of soul and funk. And then I grew up with Brandy, and I saw how she took 60 vocals and made instruments out of them. And I just had inspiration from everywhere. And I just all tried to combine it into one genre, which is me.
Yeah, you're so well-rounded. You also write songs for other people. Is it hard to write this song that you're so connected to at one moment and then let it go?
Sometimes it is, and sometimes they change it and there's nothing you could do. But in the end, like, the fans love the songs that I've written for other people, and their fans love it. So that's a beautiful feeling. And watching them, like watching Rascal Flatts perform the songs that they wrote for them in an arena is like the coolest thing in the entire world. I watched John Legend the other day sing Like I'm Gonna Lose You on his tour, and I just got goosebumps all over my body. It's crazy.
Yeah, beautiful song. All right, you're so well-rounded. You're also in TV shows, Top Chef Family Style. Give us the premise of this and how it's a little bit different than some of the other Top Chef series.
Top Chef Family Style allows young kids and their family members to compete. So we have like a 9-year-old with his mom, or a 12-year-old girl with her dad, and we have aunts and uncles and grandparents on the show, and it's beautiful to watch them support this younger child and their family, because I had amazing support growing up with my music, and they compete together, they work together. But it's funny because I thought it was like a team thing, but these kids are really like, step aside, auntie, like, you chop up the onions, I'm gonna cook the meal. So they really came to win, and they compete, and I got to eat real good food, and I learned a lot.
Yeah, I love that type of stuff, because if I could get my son interested in that, I could, under the guise of being on a show like that, he could have dinner ready for us every day, right? All right, Clash of the Cover Bands, which is something that's totally in your wheelhouse. And when you say cover bands, it's like when people walk through the door, you think the real band or the real performer is there.
Yeah, there were rumors that there, like, people in the building that we were filming in were like, did you hear that Cher's here today? Our show was just rooting them on and trying to find the best winner who could then eventually perform on Fallon Tonight Show and win a bunch of cash. So it was really fun and competitive, and a great time.
Yeah, and a bigger story there than just being a cover band, right? Because you saw that transformation. It took work. It took tweaking.
Oh, yeah. They give their whole lives to this.
Oftentimes, I'm asked the question, how do I make it? How do I make it? And, you know, the only advice I can give is just keep doing your craft, right? Don't give up on that. Sometimes it's your passion. Sometimes it can become your livelihood. What's your best advice for all the artists out there?
Today, if I was in my bedroom writing songs and I'm, like, in high school like I was, I would be like, get a TikTok, honestly, and like, just like gain a platform there and get your music out there and keep writing. And my dad always told me, like, you're not great until you write 500 songs and then 1,000 songs and then just keep going. And I still hear myself get better and better as I work on my craft. And now, like, being on TV shows is a new craft for me, and it's a new skill set that I have to learn. And I'm just trying to get better and better.
Yeah. And like for so many people, the focus is on the end of the game, the awards and the fame, and they miss out on the journey to get there. Don't miss out on that journey.
Oh, do not miss out on that journey. Also, having like a supportive team is the only reason why I'm here. Like my family members have been so good to me and so supportive. Even before when I like wasn't that good at writing songs, they were like, you're a songwriter. This is you. You're our superstar. So having that was everything.
Meghan, thank you very much for spending time with us today. We look forward to what other music comes our way. Look forward to the TV shows. I know you have to go right now, so I have only one more thing to say. Baby, don't you know that I'm done?
Sing!
Thank you.
I love you so much. Thank you.